Hi, I'm Rolene Strauss, a professional life coach and also director at RevitaHealth.
Hi, I'm Ledivia Strauss. I'm a medical doctor. I'm also a director at RevitaHealth and doing the physical medical work at RevitaHealth. We often talk about mental, spiritual and physical well-being as though they are three separate entities. But we should really start looking at all three of them together and focus on all of them to become complete, healthy human beings.
Yes, so I think it's a time in not only South Africa, but in the world where it's so important to focus on our holistic well-being. So tell me, Dr. Ledivia, what have you done to focus on your mental health?
Well, I definitely used this time at home to reevaluate what I allow in my life. I went and I made a list of all the things that are really going well in my life, mostly the things I like, and then also a list of the things that are not going so well, and those are mostly the things I dislike. And I went and I tried to work out an action plan, one action for each of these items to decide what I can do to better, especially the things that are not going so well in my life. And I came up with three questions that made this decision a bit easier. I asked, is it something that needs attention or can I just simply let it go? Is it something that I maybe can delegate to somebody else? Or is there something I can do differently to make it easier for myself?
Yes, that is such an easy and practical way to reevaluate what's going on in our lives. And it's so wonderful that you mentioned you want to make sure of what you let into your life. And it reminds me of a certain quote and then also a story that opened up my eyes to mental wellness. And I'm not sure if you've heard of the quote that says, familiarity breeds contempt.
Oh, yes.
The things that we are familiar with, the things that happen to us every single day, we don't really recognize and we don't really appreciate anymore.
Yes.
The things that usually we get for free are the things that we don't appreciate anymore. And if you think about it, the things we get for free are actually the most valuable. Think about it, your health, your mind, and your brain. Your brain is such a powerful organ. And I would love to tell you the following story that really opened up my eyes. Imagine you are standing in front of a big fertile land, a farm, and in your one hand you have a corn seed and in your other hand you have the seed of a poison plant. You have this amazing fertile land and whatever you plant in this land will grow. So what will grow if you plant the corn seed? Corn will grow. But what will grow if you plant the poison seed? Poison will grow. And our minds are very similar to a big fertile land. Whatever we plant in it will grow. And in a time as this, it is so vitally important to make sure that you allow the positive things to be planted in your mind. And you are in control of what you plant in your mind. Make sure that you allow the positive things to be planted in your mind and maybe ask yourself those three questions to make sure that you allow the things you want to allow into your life and into your mind, because we are so much more powerful and our minds are so much more powerful than we think.
That's very true, thank you. And what I think is also important to mention, like you said, what you plant will grow, but what do you water this plant with? And that is I think where it comes in, what do you allow in your life? What do you allow your mental state and your physical state and your emotional state to be watered with?
Yes.
So I think that's also very important to reevaluate what we water the seeds with that we are giving our minds.
Exactly. Thank you very much for the wonderful conversation we could have.
Yes.
And thank you for watching. We would love to hear what you want to learn from us and what you want us to talk about. And if you have any comments, please share that with us. Let's look at our wellness on a whole different level in a time as this.
Please stay well. Bye-bye.